Hey guys, Frank here. Today I want to talk about soldering irons. I've had the biggest problem with soldering irons, just finding ones that'll work right. And I want to share with you what I've learned about soldering these 18650 cells, just so that you don't make the same mistake as I did, because I've gone through and I've tried soldering irons like this, which is a good soldering iron, and I've tried soldering irons like this, which is crap. And I get different results. So what I'm going to show you today is what I've done research on, what I've tried, and maybe some tips on soldering itself, and I'll show you what I've actually found. So let's get into it. Hey guys, this is Frank and this is the DIY Engineer channel. If you are into anything like just DIY, then this is the place for you. Subscribe below, leave comments, let me know what you think, and I'll see if I can get back to you as soon as I can. So now let's get over and talk about soldering irons, because that's a grief that I've ran into and something that has not been, well, a lot of fun, but I've actually figured out a solution and I'm happy with it. So let's talk about it. Okay. All right. So what I want to talk about is these different soldering irons. I did go and have tried several different things. I initially started out with these two soldering irons, trying to solder battery cells. Well, the problem I ran into is they just don't seem to get hot enough. This one here, I don't even know what the amperage is on end. I think this came out of my dad's toolbox or something. This is like an old one that was just kicking around. And it's probably a, I don't know, probably a 40 amp. I don't know, it's, or 40 watt. Anyways, it's not very good. This one here is a little more powerful and it actually worked out really well, except for the fact that I was going through tips to see if I can get that tip. See, I was just burning them up. And I was tinning them. I was cleaning them. I was working with them. I just burned them up. They didn't want to last. So I went and I bought this welder soldering iron, which worked out really well. This here, I think, is a 60 watt soldering iron. It has the little LEDs on the front. This wasn't bad, and it's actually kind of nice for doing small little things. But when you start trying to get these batteries and these bus bars to heat up, it gets to be a problem because it takes a long time for this to get hot enough. And so I'll end up holding it on a cell for a long period of time. And that's not a good idea, because what you're doing is this iron is heating up and it's transferring that heat into the cell. And the longer it sits there, the deeper that heat transfer is into the cell. So it's really not a good idea. All right, well, I went to the next level. I thought, well, let's try a nicer soldering iron. So I went and I got this one that has the regulated. I could tune it and I could work with it. But even this one here, it takes it a while. I'm just going to rub it on this bus bar here to show you. It takes a while for that. Now it's just now starting to melt. So it's not very, well, let me grab my tool here and I'll show you. I'm going to pull one of these fuses off and show you kind of how long it takes to heat up one of these cells to get just enough to get the fuse off. So let me grab hold of the fuse here. And I'm going to try to heat this one up. So one, two, three. It took me about 3 seconds of being on that to get that hot enough to be able to remove that piece of fuse. And on the bus bar, it's probably going to take a little bit longer. There, it came loose. So it does work, and it is a decent soldering iron. And I will keep this because I like it. It hasn't burned up tips. It comes with a cleaning pad. You know, I got a sponge and I can clean it and I can tin it. So this is actually a really good soldering iron. I just don't think it's strong enough for doing cells. So I went and bought this thing at Harbor Freight. I thought, I need something that can do it. Well, this one here was touted at something like 118 watts, 180 watts. Wow, that's cool. That's hot. So I started using it, and sure enough, it started working out, and it was going great until I started burning up tips. I just went through the tips like crazy. And it, performance-wise, it's very heavy. It only works if you're pulling the trigger. And if you're doing a lot of soldering like this, you just burn it up. You burn it up, it just, it's gone. So this, not such a good idea. All right, so I went and got this welder. This is a 100-watt welder. And this soldering iron here has just been a jewel. This thing is absolutely incredible. Now, it gets hot. You don't want to slip and touch that wand. But having it on these cells, so if I grab another cell here, see if I can show you how much faster this one is. If I just go in and just, if I can grab hold of it here, it pulls those right off. I mean, I'm able to solder so much faster. The other thing that's nice with this soldering iron is when I do solder, it lays the solder down nice and shiny, nice and smooth. I don't get glumps or gloppy gunk. So this is a much better solution when it comes to soldering these cells. The other thing that's nice is you don't have to have this on the cell very long. They actually will go pretty fast. Now then, some key points to having a good solder. It's really important that you have your tip. Make sure you get your tip good and clean. Make sure you're using a good cleaner to clean it. And then I've kind of gone through this tin, but I use a tip tinning, which is this little can here for tinning. And it just keeps it clean and it cleans up the, and you can see I've really used it to death. This is really not good. But this allows me to go in and actually tin this so that I get a good tip. And you can see upon tinning that, how shiny that tip is. That turned out quite nice, huh? So it's really good to keep your tip tinned and keep it clean using these cleaning sponges. It's really great. They're what do they call these? Lead-free pads. These are cleaning pads, and I just have one stuck in a tinning can, just like this one I was just using. And these are really cheap, so they work great for cleaning the tips of the soldering irons. So that's that. So the other piece of this is when you are applying to your cells, you need to make sure you use a good flux. You don't have to use a ton, it's just a little bit, and just apply it. I have a little brush that I can brush on flux with, and gives me just enough on there just so that when I do solder, the solder just lays right down. It doesn't spend much time having to get through the cells. Now sometimes you get them like this, that they become a little bit dirty looking. I don't know if you can see it. Let me see if I can grab one here, like this guy right here, where they look a little bit dirty. And that's just the flux in there. And it's partly me just learning how to do this and how much flux to apply. And so it's a learning process, right? That's why we're here. We're trying to learn something new. So hopefully this is helpful. So my recommendations are stay clear of the Harbor Freight soldering irons. They get hot, but you'll burn up tips. So you'll burn through your $15 in a very short period of time. And then these other ones are, you know, this is a nice one, but again, I was burning up tips. If I get that to focus. Yeah, this was burning up tips. This one here has been great because I have not burned up. And so the two that I have and that I recommend that I've been using personally, they are both, well, this one here is Extronic. It's model 3020, and I'll leave a link below. And the other one here is this welder 100 watt unit, and I'll also leave a link to that below. And other than that, that's pretty much all I have to say about soldering and what I've learned so far. Just know that I think, in my opinion, and it's my opinion, that the shorter amount of time you keep heat on these cells, the better off your cells are going to be. So having a hot iron that can lay the solder quicker, you're gonna have better results in the long run. It's gonna be better for your cells, you'll get a better solder, and it'll look better all day round. So with that, I'm gonna call this another video, and we'll catch you on the next one. Thanks for watching.